Hello and welcome to another ControlUp tutorial. Starting with our version 8.1, we are very happy to introduce the ability to integrate with Horizon desktop pools. In this example, we'll connect to an Horizon Cloud Pod implementation and all its desktop pools. Let's start by clicking Add EUC Environment. From the Solution drop-down box, we'll select VMware Horizon. In the environment name, we'll type a descriptive name for our environment, and in the Connection Server field, we can put the IP name of the connection server our pool resides under. And now, in the Credentials field, we'll open the drop-down list and add a new login credentials to the credential set. If you're using an existing credential set, you can simply select the appropriate one from the list. Note that if you have multiple pods, you will need to have global entitlement permissions in order to import all your pods. Great. Now, once we click OK, we can see that after connecting to one connection server, all the pods associated with the connection server, including additional connection servers, were imported into our demo environment. Now, let's take a look at some new features that were created especially for VMware Horizon implementations. Managing the pods on the organizational tree. In cases where we want to remove a pod from the organizational tree, all we need to do is select and right-click Horizon Machines and click Connection Settings. Here, under Pod Connection Settings, we have this drop-down list containing all our pods. All we need to do is to select a pod and uncheck Add this pod to ControlUp console and click OK. This pod will stay in the list in case we want to add it back in the future. New actions and column presets. On top of 100 Horizon-specific columns, we added some new Horizon-specific columns presets. If we focus on the EUC environment and click the folder view, we will immediately be able to see presets like Horizon Connection Service Environments, Pods, and Pools. Let's select Horizon Pool, for example. This preset will provide us with valuable information regarding all our pools in a glance. For example, here we can see how many machines are in the pool, the percentage of machines left for provisioning, and how many user sessions are currently active in this pool. If we want to disable the pool or its provisioning, all we need to do is use the right-click menu command added exactly for that. If we move to the machines view, we'll find another very useful action for setting machines in maintenance mode or restarting the Horizon machine. If we double-click on the machine and move to the sessions view, we'll also find a log off session action dedicated to properly log off Horizon sessions. In addition, you can now forcibly log off a session, eliminating the need to run PowerShell scripts for this action. All these actions can be enabled and disabled from the security policy pane, so only authorized roles can use them. That's it for now. If you would like to know more regarding Horizon dedicated features, please visit our website and join our blog at www.controlup.com. We'll see you on the next video.